Hello, this is Christy. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can batch export your projects in Camtasia. You probably were aware of this tool, but if you didn't know, Camtasia doesn't allow you to edit multiple projects at the same time, and also doesn't allow you to export one project while you're working on another one. So some people actually install multiple versions of Camtasia just to be able to continue working while the other projects are being exported. So if you don't have a very powerful computer or maybe you don't have time and you have a lot of projects you need to export, then you may benefit from this tool called batch production. So in Camtasia, I just have this project here, and you can find this tool in the file menu. If it's off screen, let me just pull it back in here for a second. So you have the file menu and you have batch production. But before you go there, so if I have a lot of projects that I want to export, it is best to actually finish editing all of them and then batch produce them instead of waiting for every project to be exported before you can continue working on the other ones. So I have a few projects here I'm going to demonstrate this with. So these are all projects organized by folder, and they are all Camtasia projects. If I go into one of them, I have the project and I have the files and everything else. So I have edited these, and there's quite a few of them. There's like 14, 13, and I want to just produce these videos unattended and go on with my day while they are being exported, and I can save some time by editing them all together and then exporting them. So here's how you do it. Before you go to the file menu and choose batch production, it's a good idea to define the profile you want to use to export them. So what that means is when you have finished editing, you can create a profile going to the share menu, top right in Camtasia, and go to local file. And as you have a project open, you don't want to actually export that project, but you can go to through these options here. And this only applies to one of your, to this video. If you need to export another one, you have to go through these steps again. So what you can do is going to share and go to custom production, the last option down there, and add edit presets. This is where you define production presets, which you can later reuse in the batch production window. You have some default profiles that come with Camtasia, so you can use some of these or not, but I prefer to create my own depending on the types of projects that I'm editing, and using my own options, my own preferences, and saving those. So let's create a new one just for example. So I'm going to click new, and this is opening this dialog box, which is going to be similar to the individual export wizard, but this time we're creating a preset. So let's call this one 30 FPS max quality. Okay, this is the name I want to give my preset. So I can add a description here if I want to know what it is. And I'm going to just go through the options here. So I'm going to choose MP4 because this is the profile I want to use. Then click next. Then here I want to choose, you know, my options, if I want to produce with a controller or not, the size of the video, or I can just leave use editing dimensions, which means Camtasia is going to respect what is in the individual project. Then for the video settings, you know, I said 30 FPS. So I'm going to leave 30 here. You can obviously choose other values, and the quality 75% or whatever quality you want. Change your profiles, change your audio settings. And when you're happy, click next and click finish. So now this is my profile, my preset for the export. And I am done here. Now, if I finished editing my projects and I'm ready to produce them in a batch, and then just, you know, go and do something else while they are exporting, all I need to do is go to the file menu. Again, it's off screen, so let me just pull it in. The file menu and batch production. It doesn't matter which project you have open. You you probably don't even need to have a project open. And let's go through these steps. So first of all, you can go add files and projects. So you will be adding here the projects you want to export together. So I'm gonna just open this folder where I have my projects, and all I have to do is go into each one of them and drag it into the window. Okay, go back up, drag it into the window, and do the same with all of them. It doesn't really matter what order they are in, because they will be taken in this order. So I guess maybe you can move them up and down. No, you can't. So if you really want to have them in a specific order, you can just add them in that order or not. For me, it doesn't matter, because in the end, they will all end up in the same place. One note here, this is not actually going to generate a single file for the project. So it's not like it's going to put all the files from these projects together in one big long video. It's going to create a separate file on disk with the video that you have made. So you will, in you know, if I have 13 project here, I'm going to get, in the end, I'm going to have 13 different video files. Okay, so I added all of my projects in this export production window. So now Camtasia knows where to get all of them. They are finished editing, so I'm going to move to the next step. And the next step is I want to select the preset that I've just created, or that I created in advance, for the quality and format and all of the other options. So in this drop down here, we will select the FPS 30 FPS max quality profile that we created and move on. And now I need to select a folder where I want to put the exported files. Camtasia is not going to put each file in the folder where the project is. So I have to choose a folder on my disk where I want to put these files. Okay, so I've selected a folder, exported. Here it is, there's no files in here. And now I have to just click finish. Before I do that, if you want to actually organize the produced files into subfolders, you can tick this box, and then Camtasia is going to make a folder and put each video in its separate folder so that you know where stuff is. But because the file names are different anyway, and the file names will be the name of the project file that you added. So each file, each resulting video will have the file name as the project that you added initially. So now Camtasia closes down and the rendering, the batch production window stays open and processes your video. So in this moment, you can go and do something else. It shows you the progress overall, and also shows you the project per file, the time and the progress. At the end, you'll be able to see how long each video took, if you care for that information or not, you know, it doesn't matter. I'm gonna wait for these to finish. Okay, so my files have finished exporting. And as you can see, every project produced a different file with the specifications that I have. And, you know, they're all done. I didn't even have to choose each one. It's all done it automatically. So I hope this tutorial was useful to you. If you enjoy my videos, please feel free to subscribe to my channel, share it and like it. And if you have any comments, I would be glad to hear them, any feedback and requests. And see you next time.